Hi, thanks for joining us today at Microfocus Universe. I hope you're having a good time listening to all of the great new things Microfocus is doing as we invest further in our portfolio to bring you the latest features to address the challenges that many of our customers are having and what the market is really asking for and how we're leading that charge. You know, today we're going to be talking about an integration that really derived from customer needs. And that's data access governance. So my name is Shadi Zaire. I'm going to be joined today with Richard Cabana, and we're going to be covering data access governance, what that really means, and how that should be integrated into your identity governance and administration challenges and really solutions, as they're really one and the same and really heading towards that space. We see many of our customers build a very mature identity management solution and governance in addition to that. And then further down the line, that really extends past the application layer and also into the unstructured layer. So this is what we're talking about here. We have on the left the structured data side, and that's going to include IGA, or identity management, identity governance, really handling a large portion around automating the identity lifecycle, providing you a way to do access certifications and things like that to ensure you're enforcing principle of least privilege for your structured data or access to applications. What we have here on the right are all those unstructured data and the permissions associated with them to really gain access and ensure that users only have access to the correct file shares, the correct collaborative storage. Maybe it's access in OneDrive, SharePoint, or Teams. And usually these things are kind of thought of as separate entities, right? You have the identity team, the IGA side working on their challenges, and the data owners working on their challenges. And really what we see is that there is a huge opportunity to combine these into what we call data access governance, because really both of these processes should be thought of as identity driven. So in order to show you how identity plays a crucial role in data access governance and how you can manage both application permissions and file share permissions with this type of solution, I will be covering the governance side here on the right. And what that really means is I'm going to be showing you how we can translate what's usually very complex, you know, the NTFS file share permissions and that permission model, how it's nested, where the inheritance is, and all of that, how we can translate that into a format that the line of business can understand. That can be somebody like a manager, an application owner, going into the typical, you know, quarterly access reviews and things like that, where they may already be certifying application permissions, but now we can include file share permissions as well. So we'll show you how that looks like from a simplified perspective for the line of business. Then I'll hand it over to Richard, and he'll show you from the data owner perspective how you can get that deep dive analysis, provide visibility to the data layer, to the unstructured data, how we can protect and automate all of that and ensure we're working on both sides, right? You're automating the unstructured data and that permission model along with the application layer that you may already be doing with the identity management solution or governance solution today. And then I'll be showing, of course, the line of business side. So let me go ahead and switch to my demo environment and we can jump right in. All right, so here we are in the demo environment. And just to set the stage a little bit, I'm currently logged in as Brent Winters. And he's somebody in the line of business that has responsibility for reviewing access to the finance file share. And so we have two reviews that are assigned to him. One is the typical time-based review. And that's the first one we're going to go into. This is the typical review process and the most common one that you'll see, where a business is tasked with the need or requirement to review access on whether it's a quarterly basis, a yearly basis, but think of it as a pre-scheduled type of review process. So really what goes on in the back end is that we collect the permissions, we're collecting them all the time, but we kick off this type of process based on a schedule. And the reviewer has to go in and certify that access. And typically what it is it's application permissions. But because we have data access governance working in the background and identity governance plugged in and pulling in all of that abstracted information in, we're going to see how easy we can make it to review unstructured data permissions or file share permissions just like you would with application permissions. So let's go ahead and click on this review. And what we see here is this review and the way that it's defined in the review definition is that it's grouped by user by default. And Brent is responsible for reviewing all users that have access to the finance file share. So if we expand one of these users here, Alvin, we can see that Alvin has two different permissions assigned to him. And we'll see here immediately that we actually are abstracting what's usually a difficult or complex to understand NTFS file share permission, because on the file system side, it's usually represented with letters and abbreviations, maybe things like FM and ELR and those types of things. Those aren't things that a typical line of business user is going to understand. So what's going on in the background is we take in those permissions, abstract them, and present them in governance in a way that somebody in the line of business can understand. So we can see here that we're pulling in the path of that storage, of that file share for the finance department, and then we add on what type of permission or what they can do in that particular file share. So we can see here that Alvin has the ability to read and write that particular or to that particular file share. If we expand it, we can get more information as to how the permission relates to Alvin. One of the first things I want to call out is that we do a really great job at providing decision support to enable the reviewer to make the appropriate decision. So we can see here, what we're doing here is saying that this is authorized by Alvin's business role. And what a business role is, just to summarize, is that identity governance can do kind of what we call role mining, but it's doing a correlation type of activity where it looks at users, their job function, and what typical permissions those types of users may have. So think of it like a template or a collection of birthright permissions or something like that. For Alvin, we're saying that users like Alvin typically have the ability to read and write to that particular file share. They may also have other things, you know, as it relates to application permissions and things like that. In this particular review, it's been kind of slice and dice and configured to only look at file share permissions, but you could extend that and have application and file share permissions all within the same review. It really depends on the business requirements and how you want to have reviewers, you know, review the population. So we can see here immediately, authorized by business role. Okay, great. We think it makes sense for Alvin. We get some additional statistics, which governance is also providing. So we can see that 12% of all users have this permission. So not many people have it. But on the next line, we see that 100% of all users who are like Alvin have this permission. Okay, makes sense. You know, in the event that the reviewer wants to learn a little bit more about Alvin, we can expand this. Alvin's a budget analyst, so it makes sense that he has this type of access to the finance file share. We can get some additional attributes and things like that about Alvin, see who he reports to, and all those types of things, right? What we see here on the right is a risk score. Now, you can configure risk calculation and, you know, how everything kind of comes together to calculate this particular risk, but it's really meant to do two things. The first thing is that it provides context in this type of review. Alvin is a pretty typical budget analyst. He has roles that are associated with his business function, so his risk score is low. So, you know, it's providing context and letting us know that Alvin is within compliance, kind of what we expect for that typical user. We can also leverage risk scoring to kick off what we call micro certifications or policy designated to analyze and look at how user risk is changing, you know, over time or as an event occurs. So let's say Alvin gains direct access to a particular file share, right? It didn't go through an approval process. That's going to elevate his user risk score. And as that risk score goes up, we can immediately kick off what's called a micro certification. So if we go back to the review, we can see, okay, we just looked at the typical time-based review cycle. Well, that takes great care of the typical type of processes that you may have. However, with governance, we've extended those capabilities and really built on top of the mature event-driven model that we've been doing in IDM for many years. We've pulled in those capabilities and embedded it into governance so you can look at things like user risk score. You can look at things like let's monitor high-risk permissions. And as an event occurs, we can immediately trigger what we call a micro-certification. But you can think of it as an event-driven certification. And what it really is a certification that's solely focused on managing and really taking visibility into particular permissions that you want to monitor. So in this particular case, we're looking at monitoring anybody that gains access to change permissions on a file share, because that's pretty high risk, right? That's like having rights to be able to add new users, change what groups have the ability to do what to those specific file shares and things like that. So we want to always monitor it. Whether it's coming through approval process or direct access, we want to capture them all one and the same. So when we click on this, we're going to see it's viewed a little bit differently. Instead of managed or organized by user, we're just going to put everything up on the screen so we can very quickly see who has access and why they have it. So what we see here is that these users, Bo and Cinti and Ginger and all these other folks, you know, they have the ability to change permissions to the finance department share. So this is a little bit different type of review. As you can see, the experience is different. We're still doing the abstraction and simplifying it for the line of business user. But by using some of governance's advanced capabilities to trigger off an event, you can have your time-based reviews, and then you can have your second line of defense to ensure that you're monitoring all those high-risk events. So that way you're not blind in between the time-based certifications, right? You can have visibility into high-risk events, into when user risk is changing, or like this particular case, we want to monitor very specific permissions because we've deemed them as permissions that need to be monitored continually and not just on a time-based review cycle. So we're not going to go by and look at this, you know, expand this. It's going to look very similar to the other review. you can see here actually that it's not authorized by business role, so you'll see what that looks like. But as a reviewer, you know, you can decide to keep or remove, keep with comments, remove with comments. You can enforce all those different capabilities. You can change the reviewer. And whenever you decide to keep or remove, we can hook in with identity management fulfillment, automate that process. So that way, you're really able to plug in with existing identity management processes, take care of the governance requirements that you may have, and at the same time, extend that to the unstructured data requirements that you may be thinking of later down the road and want to tackle in this type of solution. So I've just shown you from the line of business perspective how we can simplify the end user experience, provide them with the visibility that is usually very difficult to understand, but data access governance is making that relatively painless and providing it in this type of experience. So now I'm going to hand it off to Richard, who's going to show you from the data owner perspective how you can get all those in-depth details that you may be looking for, and also ensure that you can maintain, automate, and protect your file shares as well. So Richard, I'll hand it over to you to take over.
Thank you, Shadi. What Shadi just demonstrated for you is represented on the fourth circle of this diagram, and that's the ability to meet attestation requirements through data access reviews. He showed you two types. One of them was a quarterly review, which is common among most identity governance vendors, but he also showed you one unique to NetIQ, and that's a micro-certification, which is triggered for an immediate attestation review when we see some sort of anomaly in security. What we're going to do now is we're going to walk you through and show you how File Reporter can gain you greater visibility into data and access permissions and provide you with that tie-in to identity governance. We go further with the Data Access Governance Suite, however, and we also provide you the ability to use a product called File Dynamics in conjunction with Identity Manager to protect and monitor all of the security around your high-risk data areas and provide the ability to quickly provision or deprovision storage for collaborative users or for home folders of users, and also revoke security or permissions around users that have gotten access to data stores that they shouldn't have access to. Finally, we're going to tie it back to the identity governance story by show you how we tied back File Reporter into identity governance to provide you with that high-level review of permissions on the file system. Let's walk through how data access governance provides policy-based management to your unstructured file system. What we're going to show you here is how we can perform a security analysis by doing scans on all of your unstructured data volumes. And in this particular example, we'll show how we could create automatically some reports that will give us in-depth information on the finance folder, pass that information onto a security data owner who could analyze this and establish approved access protocols, which can then be fed into file dynamics, another component of data access governance, and provide you with the ability to monitor, correct, and auto-certify the security and access policies around the unstructured files. So one of the things we do immediately is we can notify you if any of the security models have changed on the data within the unstructured file system. So anybody who's part of the data ownership would be notified through email. We can also provide you with the ability to lock down the security so it's not allowed to change. For instance, in the finance folder, we can ensure that if somebody immediately provides security access to somebody through a direct assignment or some other means, we can revoke that access and again notify the security data owner. Or we can use fencing to ensure that somebody who's a member of something such as the accounts payable group in finance could not possibly also be a member of accounts receivable. We can also show you how we tie this back through the data governance policies by using File Reporter and tying that in through identity governance and arriving back to where Shadi started us off, showing us the data attestation tied in with unstructured data as well.